Everyone can be a product, startup, business nowadays using AI. You have so many leverage. When we hear the buzzword vibe coding, it sounds effortless, almost lazy. And that's the big misconception. The biggest challenge most founders, product manager face is no longer building. Building is cheap nowadays with AI. It is building something people actually want. So in this video, I've partnered with Base44 to show you a powerful framework that puts product thinking first, turning your simple ideas into your next validated startup, business, or maybe even just a profitable side hustle. Let's dive right in. So every great product starts with an idea, but the best ideas are born from understanding a burning problem. It might be a frustration you have personally experienced or a gap you have observed in the real world. For this video, my starting idea is the language learning platform targeting working professionals. Because as a non-native English speaker myself, I know the struggle of applying spoken English in different business communication scenarios. So that gap is the burning problem. Once you have this idea, it leads into our three-stage AI building process designed to make sure we're building the right thing with a user-first mindset. Stage one, AI market research. So first, we'll use AI to do deep audience research, find real customer pain points, and spot feature gaps in the market. Stage two, AI product prep. So then we'll turn that research into a professional product requirement document, or what we call PRD, letting AI to do all the heavy lifting. And stage three, AI build. So we'll feed the requirements into our vibe coding tools to build a functional application. And I'll be using Base44 as a demo. All right, our first step is to use AI for research. To make sure these product ideas is backed by data, I'll be using ChatGPT deep research for this. But if you prefer using other AI models like Gemini deep research, Claude research, Grok deep research, is absolutely fine. So now I am on ChatGPT. Turn on deep research, saying I want to build an English language learning platform targeting working professionals. And then also to research the existing market, focusing on competitor analysis, user pain points, feature gaps, the decision factors, and also to ask it to focus on real user feedback from Reddit forums. So we are really getting what real users are thinking about. After 8 minutes, we have a comprehensive report covering the core features from competitors and the market feedback and the user pain points, especially the feature gap section. So here is gold, because it tells you what are the opportunity gaps exist on market and what are the features your product should have in order to better serve your target customers. So once we ready the research, stage number two is crucial. So you have heard the phrase garbage in, garbage out, right? It's 100% true for AI. If you give it a vague idea, you will get a vague product. So we have to formalize this into a proper product plan. It doesn't have to be complicated, but it will make a huge difference, and you will know why in a minute. And now in the same chat, ask ChatGPT to base on these research insights and discussions to prepare the product requirement document, which we'll be using on Base44 or any vibe coding tools. It should cover the brief description, target audience, three core functionalities, essential user journey, user flows, design guidelines, and most importantly, what should be included in the first MVP version. And the generated output, you can see, is simple enough. Since we are using a vibe coding tool, we don't want to make it super comprehensive, but just with good enough details and directions for AI to do the initial build. But I also highly suggest reviewing the content, so to see if the first version scope is something that you like or if anything to adjust. But there is one more crucial step here. We also need to provide some visual direction. So let's also grab a few screenshots from your competitors or any other market leaders for layout reference. And it doesn't have to be a direct competitor. And that means the product requirements will tell the AI what to build, and the screenshots will show it how to lay out. All right, we have our research, product requirements, visual guide. It's time to build something real fast. And that's why we need a vibe coding tool like Base44. I know most people are skeptical, but the whole point of vibe coding is never about replacing programmers. It's about shipping your ideas quickly for real market testing. Now head over to base44.com. So you can just open a free account. It will already have some free credit load, and you can feel free to use my code when sign up to get 10 more free credits. So for your own side projects or startup ideas, and then just click start building to start vibe coding your first application. application. So here you can see there is a prompt field where you can just describe the app that you want to create. And if you have no idea, there are also some pre-built prompt to get you started. And you can even add some pre-built style instruction. So first, upload back the product requirement files and the screenshots, and then ask it to build this platform using all the attachment files. And immediately, you can see it starts creating the app. So the AI is initiating the thinking process and then creating the pages and modules. And then after around 5 minutes, the initial build is ready. It's pretty fast, to be honest. And it's using the color scheme from the reference I upload, which is nice. And it first starts on the onboarding page that we specify and the user requirement to personalize the learning journey. And when I click on the other subpages like the learning modules, speaking practice, they now return 404. And that means these pages are not yet being built, which we're going to build later. All right, so let's try the onboarding process, pick the role, learning goals, and let's pick the beginner level. Then, whoa, it directs me to the dashboard, which is pretty impressive. Imagine we're still in the first build. And with all the call-out boxes to recap the learning progress, quick actions, recommended lessons, and I can see these are all following my product requirements. And that's why you see product requirement document is so important in the first place, because you will likely get a satisfied build in the first shot. But again, these buttons will link to the missing pages that we're going to fix later. And now let's also click here and go to the dashboard for a second. So here is like the backend for your application, the app overview, the user database with different attributes, and the app database like the learning module details. Base 44 is like an all-in-one platform that has the built-in database functionalities for you. And then with the built-in analytics already done for you as well. Also the code files if you prefer to check the detailed code files if you have some technical backgrounds. And we will come back to the other setting in a minute. Now let's ask it to build the missing functional pages for us. But before that, Base 44 has a feature that allows you to set your preferred AI models for the coding process. So you can pick Claude, Gemini, GPT model, and I would just pick Claude because it's good for coding. And then you can also set the custom instructions to make sure the AI models follow through for the upcoming building process. It also gives you the option to freeze or unfreeze any page. So for example, for some pages, you want to make sure AI to keep them unchanged throughout the building process. All right, now let's ask it to build all the missing functional pages, and then it updates the whole applications after 3 minutes. And this time, the learning modules is ready. It looks pretty good, and also with the filter, which I like. So the user can now select any particular category and also the learning level. Other pages are properly built. The speaking practice page, which you can select different practice scenarios, vocabulary review section, that is pretty nice. And then also the progress dashboard and also the user profile page with all the user learning background and preference. So this is awesome. And now let's also ask it to add back the missing individual modules. In just a minute, the module page is ready with the module learning objective and sections. So the actual learning content might look pretty simple or dummy now because I haven't really provided any learning module data to Base 44. But you can prepare that and load it back using the built-in database. And I would say the experience is pretty nice. I can really go through each section, complete it step by step, take the practice exercise, complete the modules, and keep track of the progress. So it's all functional. Now it's time to fine-tune the function details. So first, for the vocabulary, we will ask it to add the phonetic transcription for each of the vocabulary. But however, it is showing the IPA format, which I don't want. But after a few attempts, so you can see it's still not getting it right, even though I have uploaded the screenshots. So in case you encounter similar situations, what you can do is to roll back to the last message where you make these changes and then click revert this. So what it does is it will undo all the changes as if it has never happened. And the application will immediately roll back to the previous versions for that message. So let's try some other things. This time, also try adding more sophisticated features. So for each vocabulary, let's also add a listen audio features. So user can learn by listening to the correct pronunciation. And I would say the changes are being made pretty fast, just within 3 minutes. And there is a new listen icon added. And let's try it.
Deliverable.
So you can hear that this is really impressive. So now user can play the audio for any vocabulary and learn the pronunciation. So now our app got more features, functions, and I haven't set up any API yet, and I didn't config anything, and Base44 has done it for me. So that is quite amazing and unexpected, to be honest. So let's also try a record function for this, so the user can record their own speaking and get the instant feedback about their pronunciation. So after a few try and errors, it has a new record function at us. So let's try the same vocabulary.
Deliverable.
Whoa, so you can see it gives me the score, 95%. It's pretty good, and it gives me the pronunciation feedback saying it's really close to perfect and how I can improve further and where I should pay attention. So this is absolutely amazing. Base44 has helped to build this voice recognition to the app. Again, I haven't set up any API or using any external service. It just did it. Okay, to make sure this is really working, let's try another one. This one, low-hanging fruits. And this time, I will intentionally pronounce it wrong and see if it can catch it.
Low-hanging fruit.
You can see it's 100% working. So this time I score only 60%, and it says I need more practice and guide me on what are some specific pronunciations I should emphasize and focus on. So it is all working now, and the user can now just click any of these vocabularies and keep track of the learning progress. Now that we have almost done all of our core features, we can try to fine-tune some of the aesthetic details. So Base44 has these visual added features, so when you click on it, you can see every element can be selectable. And then you can just select the elements that you want to customize. So for example, I want to change the background color for this box, and then just pick the color that you like and save it. So you don't even need to prompt AI to do that. Or maybe you want to change the headlines, titles for any section, so you can just select it and change it. So this is very simple. But if you want to make bigger scale changes that these features can't help, you can just prompt AI whatever design changes that you want to make, and it will do it for you. So for example, I want to change the background color to orange. And even sometimes you might just want to chat with it and brainstorm the solution without making any changes to your app. You can just click this chat mode and then ask whatever question that you have. So for example, what additional business language topic should we add to this platform? So it will give you the response before even making the changes to your app. So our platform is almost ready to launch. So it's time to set up some of the app settings. The first thing we want to set is to customize the app logo. So you can just upload whatever your logo you like, or you can just ask it to generate one for you. Then we will need to set up the user authentication. So go to authentication and turn on the authentication method that your app should support. So for our case, we will enable the email and Google login. And then also go to the app settings to make sure the email and password authentication is enabled. And then under the app visibility, make sure it's public and set to users are required to log in to access. And here you can also set what is the main page as your default landing. So that is the onboarding page for our case. But that is not enough. We want to make sure our app is secure, as security is a big part of vibe coding. So if you don't have any technical knowledge, the best way is to have someone experienced to check the codes for you. Otherwise, you can also use the built-in security scan from Base44. So just go to the security and then click start security check, and it will scan the database settings and the key functions to see if there are any loopholes. And then you can just apply the fix to make sure some of the important data is not being accessed by all the users unintentionally. Now, before we even click publish, let's get the share link and preview it first. So now the user will be prompted to sign in to our app, which is by design. And let's try to sign up with a new account. So the UI is very intuitive, and Base44 even handles the email verification for you. So this is quite impressive. And now we can just log in using the account I just registered. And then I will be led to this onboarding page as expected. before even seeing the dashboard. So this is perfect. And now we can just click publish to make it live. And the app is now ready to use, accepting new user to register, and they can take the learning modules, the speaking practice sections with AI roleplay, and learn vocabularies. And if you're interested in trying this app as well, I will put the link down below. Vibe coding tools like Base44 can help you build MVP super fast, but a product without enough user intent is still just another great idea. So a bonus part of this process is to also build a waitlist. Again, we can just ask ChatGPT or AI to give us the marketing copy for the waitlist landing page based on the product version. And then also to prepare the product hero image, and we'll ask Base44 to build this wishlist for us. And we can fine tune the layout, the colors, hero image size, anything to make sure it looks good. And now the waitlist page is ready just within a few minutes. So it is fully functional that connected to the built-in database on Base44, capturing new emails, and we can even check the full waitlist database from the backend, where we can export the full list later. So now you can just promote this waitlist landing page without even building anything, or maybe just a really simple MVP. And I also highly encourage you to integrate payment to this landing page. So Base44 has integration with Stripe payment, so you can further validate the market. Not just your product ideas, but someone is really willing to pay you for this product to solve the pain point. And after vibe coding different product ideas myself and playing around these vibe coding tools, I can tell you vibe coding is not magic like what most people tell you. It requires your strategic thinking, your judgment, your patience to create truly valuable products or tools. First, think like a product manager. Think product, think user, think problem. Have a clear product vision before even touching any AI tools. Treat AI as a building partner. Discuss, iterate, but stay obsessed with solving real problems, not perfect builds in one shot. Second, shift fast and fail fast. If your goal is to build a startup eventually, all you need is to collect data, feedback as fast as possible so that you can get more clarity with your domain expertise to fine-tune your products and pivot. Your product first version will never be your final version. And third, leverage AI where it fits. Like in this demo, I got stuck in the process of making the record function work on Base44. I'd eventually export the project files and ask ChatGPT to review the project code files and debug for me. Surprisingly, it helped me fix it with just one attempt. So the key takeaway is don't be afraid to break out of your primary tool. Be flexible when you hit a wall, knowing the right AI for each specific task. If you enjoyed this video, bop the like button below to make sure more people can see this message. Join my community if you want to learn how to be more thoughtful of using AI and not just chasing tools. And before you go, also check out my entire video playlist about AI. See you next time.